You're right. The fourth one would have came out this year.
Yeah, Before Sunrise came out in 1995, Before Sunset in 04, Before Midnight in 2013. If Linklater had kept to the same release pattern, the fourth movie would have come out this year, 2022.
God, what do you think the fourth one would have looked like?
I don't know. Last time we saw Jesse and Celine, their relationship was not looking too hot.
I don't know about that. I mean, yeah, they fought. And Before Midnight was a hard watch, don't get me wrong. But we saw in Sunrise and Sunset how deeply they love each other. I think in the fourth movie, we would have finally seen that love prevail.
Okay, that's a little romantic. A little too romantic, I'd say.
I really don't think so. I mean, look at what they've been through. In 1995, we met Jesse, the romantic American who decided to backpack Europe after getting dumped by his girlfriend in Madrid. And Celine, the cynical Parisian who was still hopeful enough to get off the train with a boy she had just met. We saw them open up to each other, open up to new experiences, to a new world. And then in 2004, we saw them all grown up. Jesse was married and had a son. Celine was dating a new boyfriend. And they talked about the hopeful nature of that one night 9 years ago and what it meant to them.
Or what it did to them.
True, but I think that's what's so great about the trilogy and the on-screen relationship of Jesse and Celine is the way that they depict love. All three movies do it in such an honest way and encapsulate everything about the word. The beauty, the perfectness, the greatness of it, but also the awfulness, the pain, the regret.
I think you're right. I think certainly the fourth movie would have been of the latter, awful and painful and regretful. But I think that's okay. Linklater does such a great job at writing these movies that despite them being romance films, you're not necessarily pulling for the leads to end up together. But at the end of Midnight, I couldn't wait to see them apart.
I think you read out most of it. I want to see them together.
You would.
You know, it's based on a true story.
Yeah?
Kind of. Linklater had one night in Philadelphia. He saw a cute girl working at a toy store, passed her a note, see if she would hang out after they got off.
And she said yes.
And she said yes.
Go Rick, okay. Mm-hmm. I look up to him a lot, but he is not cute enough for me to go on a date with after a crappy Toys R Us shift.
Okay, I'll admit maybe I'm a little romantic, but you gotta admit you might be the littlest bit shallow.
Ouch, I'm not shallow. I just don't trust Texas men. Besides, have you seen his haircut from the 90s?
Okay, I take it back. I have seen his haircut in the 90s. We're also talking about the same man that founded Austin Film Society in 1985. The same man that wrote and directed Slacker. The man that almost single-handedly made the Austin film scene what it is today.
And the man that made School of Rock.
See, this is the problem. You're the problem.
Excuse me?
Linklater is one of the best independent directors alive today. And still, most people recognize him from School of Rock. And School of Rock is great, don't get me wrong, but he has so many other movies that just get overlooked. It's almost an example of what's wrong with Hollywood today. Like, there are so many brilliantly written, beautiful independent movies that will seemingly always get overlooked by the Marvels or DCs or School of Rocks of the world.
Very odd choice to group Marvel and School of Rock together.
But you know what I mean. Like, it's sad how things are different now. Like, honestly, if Before Sunrise was written today, I don't even know if it would have been picked up.
You're probably right. It's too honest. There's no web slingers, no Homes of Dragons, no Dwayne The Rock Johnsons. Studios don't want to promote anything else, and audiences don't want to see anything else. And I think that's really sad.
You know what else is sad?
Huh.
The first edition of the Before Sunrise script took place in San Antonio.
No way.
Yes. Imagine, instead of the wise, sexy French Celine, it's this angsty pre-med UTSA student.
And instead of walking the beautiful historic streets of Vienna, they're walking the Riverwalk.
Yeah.
Oh,
first
no.
Kiss at the Alamo. First time they have sex by some random bench by some random dudes on their bachelor party.
No. That's not covering my ears to that. Not it at all.